Blogtalk Radio.
Unfortunately, tonight will be the last time you guys hear a song, because tonight is a special 2-hour episode to where I say goodbye to my fans and I say goodbye to my friends. So there's been reasons for this. Before I get into the show, one of my friends who is a neighbor, if you hear any weird noises in the background, some jingling, I can assure you it is not Santa Claus or his sleigh. I'm actually watching a friend's dog. My friend said to me, I got a little dog. I need you to watch it. I'm going out tonight. I said, yeah, sure, no problem. And the last time I saw this woman, she had a little mini pincher. And come to find out, apparently it's been a year since the dog died. And so now she's got a French poodle. And it's a full-size one. And it takes up my entire kitchen. And now I'm stuck here with a giant dog that I had no idea I was expecting. The miniature pincher named Hans. But now there's a giant dog here. And I'm dealing with, and I don't even know his name. I just call it Dog. Because I was so used to Hans. So that's going to be the noise in the background. Another thing before I get into the episode, the dog's making me uncomfortable because it's sitting next to my dishwasher, and every time it moves, one eye is looking at the ground, the other one's looking at me, and I don't know which one to stare at the dog with, but it's annoying, and that's the noise you're going to hear, okay? The reason why I am doing this last show is because I have been threatened with lawsuits. I have been called a fake, a phony, a piece of garbage, a piece of shit. This is what people call me. I've been accused of being in pornos. I have been accused of selling sex toys with my face on them. I have been ridiculed by people on YouTube because I watch those fucking comments. And Insane Energy puts all my stuff up there like a good friend. J-Bo knows him, okay? And here's another thing on top of it. You know, I got this friend, J-Bo, supposed to try to help me out with the show. And come to find out, he's a son of a bitch that's allowing everybody to troll me, okay? That's what's going on. And then I got a lawsuit from Tony Fattata, okay? I got the summons here. They're trying to take me to court. I got to go out. And I had a call at the courthouse today. And this is how stupid people are. Down in San Antonio, they're dumb. And if you're from San Antonio, I apologize. But you guys don't know how to run a courtroom. I called in order with the file case number and everything. And you know, and they tell me that they don't have it on case, they don't have it on file, so now I got to go figure this out, and I'm not in the mood, you know, to go down to San Antonio. And then I get Joe Gibson telling everybody that we're going to do a fist fight, something like that. I don't understand it, and it's stupid. Well, hold on a second. The poodle just got in the shit. Please hold on. Okay, anyway, so tonight, we will have conversations. I will play music that you guys requested, whether it's from people that I hate or people that I like. I would also lift all bands, anyone that wants to call it into the show, except that fucking jerk, Jesco, and that asshole, Johnny Longfeather, and Cowboy Jeff, and Tony's Toilet, and Randy Anderson. Those are the only guys that are not allowed to call. And J-Bo, you call in, you say bye, and get out of here. But that's only because I know you. That's it. Okay? And in the Salami Brigade, I'm reading you guys on Discord right now. And, you know, I said chink once, and this is the reason why I'm not going to be on there no more. And I'm not going to come on here no more because you guys don't let shit die down. And Cobra Jeff, you're not going to win me over by calling me sexy because you make fun of me all the time. But I'm going to go to take the cash. But first, let me play a song that was had money donated to me. Apparently, it's a number one hit. I got that everyone's been requesting for me to play. It's called Lord Have Mercy, and it's by Benjamin Buford Fontaine III. And I guess I'm going to play it here because, you know, it was just requested. And since the last show, I'll play it. And I'll also play other songs that have been requested on my show that I refuse to play, but I'm going to do it anyway. Well, when I find the song, because I guess it's not in my queue. Whatever. I don't care about the song. We're going to go to the first call. And I'm going to get this one out of the way just because it's here. Go ahead, 617 Boston. What do you hear? What do you say? And I know who this is, so make it quick and get out of here. Go ahead.
Yeah, So can we address the elephant in the room that's not you?
Yeah, right. Well, what do you what elephant do you want to address, J-Bo? Because my show's ending. Go ahead. Well, what do you want to say? You want to apologize? You want to talk stupid? Yeah, because I've been told someone sent me a message, an email, and you know, someone sent me all this stuff about you with characters that you're calling into my show.
Yeah, I don't know what the fuck is going on with the character shit. I've never called in with a character. I can't really do any voices, so I don't really get it. I just wanted to call and say good luck. And that's really it. I just want to say good luck and... that's it.
That's all you got to say is good luck. Okay, fine. There, thanks. Yeah, sure. You know, if you really are calling in and playing characters, you better tell me.
Why don't I say this? Why don't we just go ahead? Do you remember when I first had you do the show? Do you remember when I first approached you about doing a fucking show? Let's just go there.
Wait, no, we're not going there. The past is in the past.
No. So here's what's going down. Because you owe it to your listeners, and I owe it to your listeners, too. Do you remember the first Tony Talk show when Tony sounded like this? Yeah. Guys, here's the thing. When Tony sounded like that, Tony was supposed to do a show for two nights. It was a Brock Lesnar episode, it was a Sting episode, and I think a Ronda Rousey one. And he really wanted to do a pro wrestling show. And I'm going to continue, right? You're not going to mute me and shut me the fuck down because you didn't want this out, right?
No. No.
Yeah. Okay. So what's going down here is, and we've protected this secret long enough because I don't want to embarrass you, but I acted as you with my voice talking like this. Okay. Because I can't get that voice high like yours because you have a high pitched voice.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah, right, you do. So we protected this for a long time because, you know, we're both fucking loyal dudes and we don't rat each other out, but don't insult your fans, don't insult their intelligence anymore since this is the last episode. I was the first one that came on here as Tony, and I did this. I helped you prep for your show and showed you how it was done. And yes, I character acted. That was the only time I've ever been a character on your show. And you need to tell your fans that, and you need to apologize for duping them.
My first show.
What?
The portal licked my elbow. You know, go way down over there.
Tony.
What?
Stop fucking with the poodle and answer your fans.
I'm not fucking with the poodle. My fans, yeah, I was scared to do a show and I chickened out. And you said something that somebody was bitching at you, so you did the show.
Yeah. And that's the thing. And that person that was bitching was Joshua Higgins, because Joshua Higgins messaged me and was like, oh, you're trolling us, dude. There's no real guy. And I didn't want to look like an asshole, and I didn't want you to look like an asshole. So I went ahead and I portrayed you in big fucking deal. And I'm sure everybody caught on to it, and everybody's on with it. Tony's voice changed. Holy shit. It's a big fucking secret amongst blog talk enthusiasts. And, yeah.
Yeah. I was scared, and you took off, and you got the show going.
Yeah, and then 2 years later, you're pissing it away. So thank you for bringing everybody together, like, all kidding aside, as a community, because we all have a huge community now. And we love the show, and these people have grown to love you, and you know, and Higgins put a lot of work into getting this going too. And yeah, so that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to get this out there since everybody was always asking and destroyed any type of credibility that have of you being a real person, you know, a real person that people have donated to, who I've opened up a donation thing for you. Who I've also shared funds with Insane Energy. I didn't hog everything for myself. I didn't spend any fucking dime. Everything has always been to you. I've tried to get Tony Talk t-shirts going. I've tried to do everything. And like you're a fucking malcontent.
Okay. You know, you call it, you're saying what you gotta say.
So apologize to your fans and don't quit. And yeah, tell them the truth about the first fucking three or two episodes that I had to step in for you and save your ass, or else there wouldn't be a Tony Talk show. You wouldn't have fans for me, and if we wouldn't have fans for Higgins, if it wasn't for Higgins.
You're right. And I try to keep a secret because I'm not a rat like somebody is.
I'm not a rat. I'm just not insulting anyone's intelligence. Okay, I had a conversation with one by the name of Obese Charles, and we speak on Facebook. He's from Ireland. He's a good guy. And he even said it too. He's like, there's like the credibility for the show has been shot. It's bullshit. This is why you're more than likely losing listeners. And the only one that's keeping this thing alive right now, at first it was Spencer, but now it's what the hell is it? Insane Energy.
Yeah. And Shane. Yeah.
So, I mean, just stop insulting their intelligence. And, yeah, so there it is. There you go. There's your can of worms being opened up, T. Go fucking spend time with your fans. Thank them. Because I don't give a shit if there's 550 or 500 of them. They deserve a good show. And please do not ever accuse me of calling in as a troll. I would never do that. I'm your friend. I've been here with you literally since day one. I've seen more of you than I care to even say. I probably see more of you than I do my wife.
How is she, by the way?
Terrible. She's still married to me.
Huh. J-Bo.
See you later, too. Thanks for the 2 years.
I'll see you around the block, kid. Thanks. So there it is. Yeah, the first two episodes, three episodes. I've had J-Bo. I told him I was going to do a show, and I chickened out. And because of Higgins, he stepped in so I wouldn't lose the show. You know what? I can't do this right now. I need a break. I need a break. We're going to go with an old one here from the few of the old episodes. Hang on a second. I'll be right back.
Dip your finger to a tear in my turtleneck. You're still up dirty in the back of my mind. You'll keep on flirting, know that it's working. Stuck in my head, girl, right in the lines. Couldn't sing a song without you if I tried. Let's write it up like it's our last night. We're just hitting the shards, hitting the shards. Shipping on some poles, I'm a little jamming to some old French and natural beauty with you right here. Naked in my bed, I'm just doing my thing. You love it when I sing, say it makes you feel like an angel. We're about to get a little tangled up right about now. So girl, let's keep hitting the sides, hitting the sides, hitting the sides, hitting the sides.
Oh!
Gotta keep hitting the shots. That's right. You young bucks don't know how to hit the shots. That's why Uncle Tony's gotta sit there and sing your music to give you the information.
And that was Jason Aldean's song that I sang. But instead of saying burning it down, I was hitting the shots. Because that's what I do. Because it's thick. And you gotta hit the sides because that's what they like. 240, you're the first caller this evening. Second caller, aside from J-Bo. 240, what do you hear? What do you say?
Shalom, Tony. It's DC2, brother. I'm a little emotional.
Tony, baby.
This is going to be a serious call for all the listeners. This is not a joke call, although most people don't think I'm that funny anyway, but that's neither here nor there, brother. I just want to call to tell you that I love you as a brother, You've been good to me since I've known you. You've always let me have a voice on your show, even though a lot of people don't like me. You're a very good friend, and I'm going to miss you. But I want to say something that you should know. That in the time that I've known you, I've lost my wife. We got divorced. I've lost a friend in Joshua Higgins. I've had a family member fall ill. I've had many, many real life things happen, and the only consistent thing in my life through all of that was you. And I would not be doing my job as being your friend, Tony, if I did not come on here and tell you how much your real fans and your real friends love you, and that we do not want you to leave. Whatever the issues may be, brother, we will help fight them with you. We are your friends, brother. There is no need to leave. You are such a bright light in this dark world, brother. And I love you so much, and I don't want you to go because you do so much good. And who gives a shit if in the beginning J-Bo did something for two or three? Nobody cares, man, because we love you. And I love you, and I don't want you to leave. I'm basically, you know, my reason for calling was for all of the fans out there is to let you know how much we love you, and we don't want you to leave, man. I mean, that's real. I'm keeping 100 right now, brother. This ain't a funny call. I'm being dead serious, man. I'm emotional because when I had family sick, you reached out to me. We had conversations, brother. I mean, that's real life, real friendship, man. And I don't want your show to go away because I know what it means to me. I know what it means to a lot of other people too, man. It's not just me. It's lots of other people. And I guess my point to what I'm saying to you is, can't you reconsider, brother? I mean, can't you think about us, the people that love you, and put us above the people that don't like what you do? Because those people don't matter, Tony. They don't matter. The people that matter are the ones that listen to your show all the time, man. The ones that call every show, the ones that listen to every show, the Insane Energies, the Devons, the, you know, all those people in the Salami Brigade that love your show. You know, Mad Mark, Mr. Spark. I mean, I can go on and on. Those brothers love your show, man. And I feel like I'm calling on behalf of them just because I know how much they're hurting. And I'm heartbroken because you're like one of my, I consider you a close friend, and I consider myself blessed to know you, brother. So, you know, I just wanted to call in and just say, listen, if you need to talk off the air about whatever this craziness is going on with Pastor Ken, you know, filing lawsuits and all that horse shit, like, dude, I'll get you a lawyer. I will get you a lawyer. I'll do whatever I can to help you, brother. I don't want the show going off the air. It's too important to too many people, man. You help so many people.
And I know, Tony, and I appreciate it, you know, and I actually made this decision up a while ago because of all the stuff that's been going on, and that would explain why for about a week straight I just did a show every day, you know.
That's right,
and then I said to myself, I'm going to stay with the show because it makes people happy, but and then I'm getting a lawsuit from Tony Fattata. I got a, you know, it's just gone okay. Too much. It was supposed to be a radio show. Now it's just gone crazy.
Well, I don't think that's real. I mean, what can they sue you for, Tony? Like, legitimately, what can they sue you for?
I don't know. You know, it said something about defamation of character.
Come on, brother. That's bullshit. Listen, if there is, okay, I think there's about a 3% chance they're actually doing anything. But if they are doing anything, I'll pay for a lawyer myself to keep you on the air. Because listen, Tony, that shit will be thrown out in 5 seconds. Okay, if it's in 97%. Of me thinks it's all horse shit anyway, because that's all those two do is lie. So, brother, if I promise to take care of you, can't you just, I mean, can you take a little time off and then come back? I mean, You don't have to leave, man. I don't understand why you're letting these assholes win. Will you at least consider what I'm saying, brother? Will you?
I will. I will.
All right, man. That's really all I got. You know I love you. I'm sorry that all this is going on, man. And I will do anything to keep your show on the air, including take care of any legal fees you might have, because that's what friends do. And I know how much you love this show, and I know how much it hurts you when you see people speak ill of it and people take it to places that you never wanted it to go. But that's not on you, man. That's on them. So, whatever the case, I will take care of you, brother. You know that. I have had your back from the beginning. I'll always have your back, whether you do a show or not. But I know how much the people love you, and I'm not just going to let you walk away without fighting to get you to stay, brother. I mean, it's the right thing to do. So I hope you'll take my words to heart, man. Like I said, I love you like a brother. I know you're going through it right now. If you need me, I'm always here. Like I said, man, a lot of people love you in that Salami Brigade, and a lot of people love you outside of the Salami Brigade. So keep those people in mind, man. And that's really all I got, brother. But I just want to let you know I loved you, and I appreciate everything you've done for me since I met you. And, there's been a lot of hard times in my life. You know about Higgins. You know about my family and a few other things. I don't get through that stuff without you, man. So I appreciate you, and I hope you really take what I've said to heart and reconsider, brother.
Thank you, Tony, baby. I appreciate it. I do.
All right, brother.
We talk about Higgins, and I know Higgins appreciate our friendship, too.
Amen. Amen. But one thing I would say is Higgins would definitely not want you to leave. He would not want you to leave, brother. He would want you to keep doing the show and bringing people happiness. I know that for sure. I mean, he came up with the idea, brother.
He did. Yes, he did. Him and J-Po. They both did.
That idea was to make people laugh and give them a break from all this craziness that we call life, man. So, you know, just keep all that in mind, brother. I know you said you've been thinking about it for a while, but maybe you need to hear from the fans tonight. Maybe that'll change your mind. So I'm going to get off here and let your other fans talk to you. I love you, brother, like I said, and if you need me, I'm here. You got my number, and you know, regardless of what happens, I'm always going to be there for you, my friend, and I'll be loyal to you to the day I'm in the ground, brother. So love you. I hope you'll reconsider, and again, thank you to all the supportive fans that have been out there for the years we've done the show. And I don't know, brother. I hope this isn't the end.
Thank you, my friend.
Thank you. Love you.
Love you too, Tony, baby. That was Tony, baby. Thank you. And with that, I am going to gonna take a quick break. Gonna liven things up, though. This is one of the songs that were actually requested, and I remember when it was brought in to me, and I wasn't too happy about it, but I guess I'll play it here. Not the whole thing, because it's long. Because I want to get calls in, but I'll be right back.
Living my life in a solo head. A different guy every night in motel. I seen the sun shining all the days, and falling upon love and deep thought. Wish I had a good guy to miss me. Lord, I wonder if I ever gained my way. I put your picture away. down and cry to me. I kinda look at you while I lie next to him. I pull your picture away. I sit down and cry to me. I can't look at you while I'm lying next to him. I called you last night in the hotel, darling. Everyone knows, but they won't tell, darling. But their half-hearted smiles were telling something just ain't right. I've been waiting on you for a long time. No. Fueling up on heartaches and hashtag cheap wine. I ain't heard from you in 3 damn nights. No, I didn't want. I put your picture away. I wonder where you've been. I can't look at you while I'm lying next to him. No. I put your picture away. That's what I did. I wonder where you've been. I can't look at you while I'm lying next to him.
Okay, I'm back.
And why was that song even requested on my show? It's okay. We're going to go back to the cars. And that's not beautiful. Okay. 856. I'm bringing you on, 856. What do you hear? What do you say?
Tony, is this?
Hello?
This is Barry. This is Barry from Barry's Flower Shop and Pottery Works.
Oh, no. What? Yes, my last show, Barry. What?
Tony, I have a lot of your material here at my flower shop. I have many, many Tony Talk blow up dolls, many Tony Talk bobbleheads. Tony, why are you leaving? I have a lot of your material here, and you are leaving me. What am I supposed to do with the material, Tony?
I don't know. I don't know what you should do with the material.
I have Tony Talk t-shirts. I have Tony Talk hats. I have received so many Tony Talk items in the last 12 months. Tony, please, don't leave me. I, what am I supposed to do with these Tony Talk materials?
I don't know. You know, I didn't make them. I don't know where they came from, Barry, but I think you should get rid of them because I didn't make them. Just throw them out. The show's not on anymore. Tonight's your last episode. It's not going to be worth anything.
Well, I don't want you to leave, Tony Talk. I have a lot of your blow-up dolls here. Like, I have like 20 of them. Still in the material, and I hope they will come out, and with their little dicks.
Okay, you know what? You know, first of all, there's nothing wrong with my dick, Barry. Don't you mention, you son of a bitch. You want to call it here the last episode and talk about my dick being small?
I don't mean to be a troll. I'm not trying to be a troll. But Tony, if you're going off the air, that you say you're going off the air. My God, Tony, what am I supposed to do with all this Tony Talk material that I have in my flower shop? You know, I sell flowers.
Yeah, I know. You sell flowers in penis-shaped vases. Yeah, I know all about it. I heard.
Well, please don't go off the air, Tony, please. Because I have so much of your material here in my flower shop that I've been selling. I sold t-shirts. I sold hats. I have sold I sold Tony Talk blow up dolls. How many of them I sold? I sold three blow up dolls, and I have sold many, many Tony Talk t-shirts. So please don't go off the air. Please, Tony. Please.
Where's your money for it? Well, you sold something with my likeness and my image. Where's my money for it? Where's my cut?
Hold on. Let me see. How much do I have for Tony? Hold on. How much? How much? I have $237.50. $0.50? That's going to be sent to you. But I need your address off the air.
No,
I don't want.
I have a PayPal. You listen to me. I have a PayPal. TonyGagaTalk@yahoo.com. You want to send anything? You send it to that. I'm not giving my address out. And you, dog, get off the table, son of a bitch.
But why do you have to be such a dick, head, Tony?
You want to call me a dickhead? Get out of here. You have no more show to call. I'm out of here. Get out of here. Goodbye, son of a bitch.
No, Tony.
No, nothing. Tony. Get out of here. Don't shout things, okay? You want to sell something with my face on it? You be a generous human being. Don't be a stunad, son of a bitch. And send me the money if you're going to do that, okay? Don't be an asshole. And Tony's toilet. You tell me I farted one more time when I didn't fart. You asshole. Get out of here. Don't private message me no more. You annoy me. I'm going to block you from the chat room in 3 seconds if you don't get the fuck out of here. You son of a bitch. Tony's toilet just called me a wop. He's bothering me in the chat room, and this is why I get off the... This is why I'm not going on the air no more. I'll sign off right now if you don't stop, son of a bitch. Anyway, 907... what do you hear? What do you say, 907?
Hey, Tony, this is Madeline. It's been quite a while. Hello.
Oh, God.
Hey.
They're all calling. What do you want, Madeline? Shall
well,
I
guess
who
I am tonight? Guess who I am tonight?
I don't know, Madeline, and I don't care.
Anchorage. Do you know where Anchorage is?
It's in Alaska, Madeline. Why are you in Alaska? Why are you out there?
Because I came up looking to have sex. I came up to Alaska looking to have sex with Eskimos. So I'm in Alaska. Why don't you get on an evening flight to Seattle? You can come up to Alaska. I've got a jacuzzi in my suite at the Sheraton.
What I want to know is...
I'm already naked.
What I want to know, you're repulsive, but what I want to know is, how is it that you travel all over the place for booty calls and sex? And who would have sex with you, Madeline? And why is it always that no matter what part of the fucking world you're in, you find a jacuzzi and you're always calling me and you want me to have sex with you and I keep turning you down? And I keep turning you down?
Because I love to travel. I love to travel and I stay in a nice hotel everywhere. I stay in a nice hotel everywhere I go. I get a suite and I fly first class. You can too. Spy first class ticket.
No, I don't want it. I would not pay a first class anything to go meet you and sit in a jacuzzi with you. Why is this dog breathing on me? Go away!
Will you come to Alaska?
No! I'm not coming. Madeline! I'm not going to Alaska!
We can go ice fishing only wearing parkas. And then we can go back to the room and have naked sex in the jacuzzi.
I'm going to drop. If I don't hang up, I'm going to drop on you. Madeline, I'm glad this is my last show. You'll give me nightmares.
Then
don't
you can
call
wax
me. No.
Then we can wax each other. We can wax each other in the suite and then have a couple's massage.
I'm going to hang up before I throw up on my microphone.
No.
Okay. No, 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 noms tonight. I'm not in the mood, and I get sick, naked, fat women calling me all the time. All the time, and I don't want to deal with it no more. Why are you breathing heavy? Is this fucking dog asthmatic or something? Why do I agree to this? All because I want to hit the sides. Stop breathing in my face. You smell like, okay, this dog smells like dog food. And it's breathing in my face. I'm taking another break. I gotta take another break.
Thank you. break it down.
Okay. Oh! Jesus, I'm sorry. I burped. Good, and the dog ran away. Get out of here. Where are my cats? Five zero two. What do you hear? What do you say?
Hello, Uncle Tony. How are you tonight?
I'm not bad. What do you hear? What do you say?
I'm doing well. It is Finn.
Finn, baby, how are you? What do you hear? What do you say, my friend?
Oh, I am doing quite well, you know, just relaxing on this Friday evening. And I am sorry to hear that this might be your last show, because you are a good man with a good heart who doesn't deserve this shit that is happening to him.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yes. And even though this might be the end, for the show at least, Sven will like to wish you that the future will become better for you, and that things will lighten up at the end of the tunnel, yeah?
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Yes.
I appreciate
and
that.
Sven, sorry. And Sven only has one regret, and it is that I did not discover your show sooner, for yet it brought Sven many joy and many moments of laughter, even though there were still not too cold in. But there were still many moments where your heart and passion spoke through to inspire us, Uncle Tony.
Thank you. Thank you, Sven.
And you're welcome. And Sven would like to give a shout out to the Salami Brigade and the Blogtalk chat room, as well as the YouTube chat, for their fans who tune in to listen to the wisdom that you spout, Uncle Tony. For age is only a number, but experience. Now that is what is important, y'all.
Yes, friend. Thank you.
And I thank you for taking my call, Uncle Tony. Keep your head up, look to the skies, and keep hitting the shades.
Ah, that's a great poem. Thank you, Sven. That's good.
Thank you, Uncle Tony.
And well, even though I end the show, I'm still going to be in the Salami Brigade, so I'll see you in there, Sven. Thank you for your call, buddy. I appreciate it.
Anytime, Uncle Tony, you have the good rest of the night.
You too. Thank you.
Welcome.
That was Sven. He's a good listener. And not a piece of garbage. 210? What do you hear? What do you say, 210?
Hello. It's Grover Washington. It's Grover Washington. I'm down here at Haverford Meter Street. Down here in San Antonio. I'm outside the mission right now. Hold on the train.
Did you try to have sex with a train?
No. Oh. My dick somehow got on the electric line. But I'm okay now. Speaking of my dick, I just want to say Barry's got the blow up dolls. There's a lot of guys up there aiming for hope who can really use them because we don't get we don't get a lot of action. A lot of men up here, red old. I'm 58 years young, and a lot of men. A lot of guys that don't get showered very much, and we would definitely mount them blow up dogs. And I tell you, it doesn't matter if it's a woman, it's a man, old as old. If you know what I mean?
God. Yeah, I know what you mean.
Speaking of blowjobs, I got a real beef with that Pastor Ken. He stood me up. The shelf, he's got a soup kitchen at his house there, and I got an email from a guy named Doug. The guy named Doug is kind of an incoherent email, but it told me that there's going to be a soup kitchen on a, I'm not going to say the street name, but it starts with an A. I'm not going to say it all, but I got an Uber scheduled. I got called in an Uber. Uber's going to take me over there for the soup kitchen. And he told me, oh, we're not going to have lie. And it was too late to cancel the Uber, so that motherfucker better pay for that Uber. And they want tips, too. They need tips. And so because of that, I didn't get my bowl job and my free meal.
You're not going to get your boss drained, Grover, because he's too busy suing me. Instead of whatever you think that he's going to do to you. He's too busy showing me. Him and his boyfriend, Tony Matata, are showing me.
Well, he fucking lied. He said he's going to have a soup kitchen, Doug told me. if you ever get a hold of that man, I want you to tell him. I'll never forgive him for this. The homeless people go through enough without this crap.
Well, speaking of Ken, I'm looking at his number right now. He's actually in the queue.
Oh, really? Oh, that's shit.
Hold on a second. Hang on, Grover. Hold on, I'm bringing him on. Go ahead, 210. What do you hear? What do you say?
Grover, my brother, yeah, you come over, I'll give you a blowjob, okay?
Well, that's what? More my speed.
Wait a second, all right, hold on, I'm being told that you're the fake Ken. It's just a...
What?
Wait a second, there's another number here too, hold on. 210, what do you hear? What do you say?
Hello, Tony. This is the real Ken. And by the way, no, we're not suing you. I don't know where you're getting your information from, but we're not suing you. Okay? We have never tried to sue you.
I got a summons in the mail.
Well, it's not a real summons. Okay, because we're not suing you.
Okay, it's a real, summons.
It's not a real summons, okay? Okay, you're getting these fake-ass people, okay, that have been betraying me for quite some time now, okay?
I'm tired of this craziness going on
your program.
Okay. You're pretending to be
me.
Okay.
Shut up, fake Ken.
Hold on. Stop it. What the? Who's making the train noises?
Train tracks. Train tracks.
Hey, Grover. Let me suck your ball train cock.
All right. I'll be down there. I need to get my balls drained.
Well, you ain't gonna get him drained by me. You're getting him by the fake Ken. Okay.
A hole's a hole for my book.
Why are there too many Never. Kens? How are these Kens? Why are there so many of them?
I don't know, Tony. You tell me.
Okay.
Can one of you talk, please, and not the other one talk over the other one? Go ahead, Ken.
Okay.
Okay.
Stop talking over me.
Stop talking over me.
He's talking over me, okay?
Our ball's drained. I gotta get him drained.
Well, get the fake Ken to do it for you. Because I'm not doing it.
Again. You did it one time. Why not two?
I never did it, period.
Yes, I did.
Okay. There's two numbers here, 210-267. I'm not going to say the last four digits. But they both match. Why do they both match?
I do not know. Somebody's spoofing the number.
I'm the real Ken.
But I'm the real Ken from 210-267.
Okay.
Okay, I've listened to your show since day one, okay? And this, you should have known me better than this. I've never called your show acting like that, okay? That's a fake Ken right there, okay? And you know it.
Here's the real Ken. I want the real Ken to give me the Ten Commandments. I want the real Ken to give me, because he's a pastor. I want the real Ken to give me the Ten Commandments.
Oh, you do.
My pod.
I am the Lord thy God. Oh, no, show, okay? Not any other gods, okay, before me, okay? Two. Thou shalt not, take the Lord of, God in vain, okay. Three, remember, to keep the holy faggot day, okay.
Okay. It's the Sabbath day, you son of a bitch.
That's right, and that's the fourth commandment. Keep the Sabbath day holy. Okay, not the third commandment.
You just said the faggot day. You said that right now. You did.
I didn't say that. That was the other Ken.
That was the what?
That was the fake Ken that said that.
Okay, it was that fake Ken that said it. Okay, and he said faggot. Okay.
And keep the Sabbath day holy is the fourth commandment, not the third.
Yeah.
Okay, and the fifth commandment is honor your father and mother. Okay, then the sixth commandment is you shall not murder. Okay, the seventh is you shall not commit adultery. Okay, the eighth is you shall not steal. Okay, you shall not give false testimony against your neighbor.
The
last one is you shall not cover your neighbor's house.
The sixth is thou shall not commit adultery. Okay.
I'm going to look it up.
I am pulling my pod.
What?
I'm beating my meat.
You know, Ken,
what, Tony?
Talking about chicken.
Why are you saying dirty things? That voice matches you. Why are you saying dirty things on the air if you're the real Ken?
I'm not saying dirty things on the air. They're playing a recording.
Shut up.
Who's
okay, don't pick some fucking cut. Okay.
Oh! Alright, I'm being respectful to you, whether you're the real Ken or not, and you're saying things like that. You're telling me to go pick
That's a recording, Tony. It's a recording.
Who's playing it?
The fake Ken is.
The fake Ken?
He's fucking himself with a dildo.
Okay. Why would you call in here and say these things to me? We're supposed to be friends.
We are friends, Tony. I don't know what's going on. You got so many people trying to play me, okay, and be me, okay, it's ridiculous. Okay,
I'm not in charge of it. I would never have somebody do that to you.
Well, that's what they've been doing, okay, for the last almost 2 months. Okay? They've been falling in with this fake ass, okay, Ken, okay, and BBF is part of it. I'm not friends with BBF. I never stayed in this compound. He's a lying son of a bitch. Okay? Okay, he didn't make
a
fun of me.
Okay? You're a lying son of a bitch. Okay?
You are a lying son of a bitch. Shut up your lying mouth. You fake ass bitch.
Shut your lying mouth. You fucking retard.
Ah!
That's you. You're the one that wears the helmet.
Yeah, you wear helmet. You're retarded. Okay.
Yeah, whatever. Okay, you can't even do my voice correctly.
Okay.
I'm a gay man, don't get me wrong.
And yeah, keep playing recording.
I know you're gay. I know. What is going on with God's Rainbow Ministries?
Nothing's going on with God's Rainbow Ministries. BBF is not part of it. He never will be. Neither is Pastor Kent. Neither is Jessica White or Randy Anderson. Nobody's a part of it. It's only me that runs GRM.
And now Spencer Rice is a part of it, too.
No, not Spencer Rice. He's not part of it.
I don't know what to do.
That was the answer. You like eating shit? Okay.
What? What about shit?
He's playing a recording.
Okay. See, no, he was just talking. Who are you saying fuck you to, me or him?
I never said fuck you to begin with.
I wear a helmet.
Okay.
There are 2-2-1-0 numbers here. 3. One of them is Grover. There are 2.
I'm beating my meat.
So why are you... Who said... Ken, I'm trying to talk to you.
Yeah.
Whoop your ass.
Why are you going to whoop my ass? I'm not doing anything.
I didn't say that. That's a recording.
No, he said it. Okay. He said it. You fucking retard.
Okay.
Masturbating sound.
I don't know what
to... Listen, honey, you can believe what you want to believe. Okay, but I'm telling you right now, I'm the real Ken, and Tony F, okay, did not sue you, okay? Okay, I know this for a fact, okay? We haven't been to the courthouse. We haven't been anywhere, period.
I got a summons in the mail.
A brown stain is a shit stain, okay?
Yeah, I'm trying to tell you I got a summons. You don't have to tell me that it's... I'm thinking about a shit stain. I don't know. I don't care. That's your voice.
I buy baby black children and you dick fuck to them.
What the
Quit playing recordings, fake Ken.
I'm not playing.
I'll whip your ass.
Yeah, I'm not playing recordings, okay?
I didn't say you were. I said the fake Ken.
I muted Fake Ken. I muted him.
Okay, that's good.
I muted him.
Whatever, man. Come on down from Boston.
That's probably Grover. That's probably the fake-ass Grover. Okay? Grover ain't real. Okay, he's a troll.
You want to go at it anytime you want to. Come down to San Antonio. Get in and I'll whip your fucking ass. Okay?
Keep playing recordings, Grover.
Oh, who are you talking to? Who are you talking to like that? You said Boston. Was that supposed to be toward me? Who was that supposed to be toward?
No, it wasn't towards you at all.
Why would you tell me to come down from Boston? Who else is from Boston that you want to fight?
Okay?
I don't know, okay, but okay, it's not you, and I'm not saying it.
Hold on a second. 666, what do you want? Clear things up right now.
He can't clear nothing up.
Lord have mercy.
Shut up, you bitch.
Lord have mercy. What is going on with you, Mary Lou? You are being upset. Why are you not admitting that you have sold gold Rainbow Ministries to me?
I have not sold nothing to you nor anybody ever. Period. You're a lying sack of shit. Okay, why don't you shut your freaking mouth? Okay, you piece of fucking dog ass shit.
Okay, that's it. The two of you are gonna talk this out right now. And I don't care. That's it. The two of you right now. Benjamin and Ken, talk it out right now and make peace. This is the last episode. We're going to make peace right here. Okay?
Okay, we'll make peace on your show, but that doesn't mean I'm going to make peace with them in real life.
Lord have mercy. Mister, listen here, Mary Lou. The other day, I was very kind to you here when you spilled coffee on Kent by accident here.
I didn't spill coffee on no one. Shut up.
Lord have mercy. You're supposed to be a man in a cloth, and you're telling people to shut up here. What have I ever done?
Yeah, I'm
going to
tell you to shut up because you're a liar. All you do is lie. Okay?
Yeah.
See? Everybody knows you're a liar.
No, sir.
Faked your own death. Okay? Okay?
That wasn't me here.
Yeah, you did.
Why
you're a liar?
Are you a piece of shit? Okay? Why are you garbage?
Why are you playing recordings, BBF?
Mary Lou, you are calling me garbage here?
Yep, I'm calling you garbage.
Sir, I allow you to be an ambassador for God's Rainbow Ministries here.
He was a great cocksucker, okay?
Lord have mercy.
That's you playing it. As you playing it.
I get more cool than you. I get more vagina than you. I get more vagina. I get more poon than you.
This
I don't
here
know who
is
that
disgusting
was supposed
here.
To be. Okay.
This here. Listen here. Mary Lou, I need you to apologize for all the turmoil you caused in my life here. And lying to people telling everybody
I
was
apologizing
dead.
For shit. Because I didn't cause nothing in your life. You caused nothing but a turmoil in my life. Why don't you apologize?
Sir, when have I caused turmoil?
You always cause it. You always cause it with your lies.
Well, what have I done?
Nobody here went back.
Lord have mercy. Why are you yelling swears here? We're trying to have a civil conversation.
I'm not yelling
Mary
swears.
Lou.
I'm simply telling you you're a liar, sir. Okay? You are a liar.
Motherfucker.
Hey, you keep playing recordings all you want. Okay?
Sir.
But that's
sir,
not me
that
saying
is,
anything.
That is not me here. That is you here.
Shut up.
That's you. That is you.
No, sir. No, sir. Listen here. I'm a man who is an upstanding citizen here. You can ask Mr.
Yeah,
Disco
right.
Why.
Yeah, you're so upstanding. Okay? It's sickening. Yeah, right. Okay? You're not upstanding whatsoever, okay? Your whole facade is a lie, Foghorn Leghorn.
First of all, sir, There's no lying here. I'm a man of God, and I own God's Rainbow Ministries.
You don't own nothing.
You're a sinner. You are a sinner, and you dress like a saint here, but you're a sinner.
Yeah, whatever. You know what? Stick your finger and stick it up your butthole and twirl on
mercy.
It.
Okay. Hold on. You guys are supposed to be making peace on my show, not insulting each other. And Ken, BBF is being nice to you, and you're insulting him.
Okay, well, I'm sorry.
Look,
all right.
What about television in 1986 here?
He's playing recording.
Put his finger in my butthole when he gave me the blowjob. He did finger in the butthole.
You need to stop giving out charity blowjobs here. That's ungodly here.
I don't give out charity blowjobs. You do.
Lord have mercy. See, now you're lying here. Now, let me ask you a question here. Why is it that you sent me a private message here on Discord? I'm going to read this on the air. Let me grab my cell phone here.
I didn't send you nothing. I'm not on Discord.
Miss Niggleford. Can I have my phone? Thank you, Bill. Thank you, Mr. Nisworth. Okay. It says here that you said that Don Cornelius, DC2 here, is a nigger.
I never said that. You're a liar.
Okay. You know, I don't want to hear that on my show. DC2's a friend of mine, and that is a very racist word. A very racist word and disgusting.
I never said
that.
Don't
say that on my show.
I never said it.
Yes, he did here. He said, DC2, he'd be a filth mouth. He said, DC2's a nigger.
No, I didn't.
Then he said, Grover's a nigger.
Yeah, right. Sure. Okay, he never said it. Never said it. Okay, why are you making things up, man? What is your problem?
You're making anything up. You're the one trying to sue Mr. Tony Gaga by sending him a summons.
I ain't trying to sue Tony Gaga at all. Okay? Neither is Tony F.
Lying, thieving bastard here.
You're a liar. Okay? Period.
Are you okay?
And you know it.
Are you okay? Are you choking over there? Who's choking?
Lord
have mercy. Oh, sorry.
Robert Grover.
I got the COPD.
Mr. Washington, I would like to make you an ambassador for God's Rainbow Ministries here.
You can't make anybody anything.
No, sir. He has found a lie, and he will no longer receive any charity blowjobs from your sinning ass here. You are a liar and a thief and a sinner, and you are trying to sexually exploit the homeless of San Antonio here.
No, I'm not. You're a liar, BBF, okay? We all know you're a liar, okay?
No,
everybody is
lying
you.
Would be
you're a liar.
About Tel Aviv and not. Don't
you're
talk
a,
over
you're
me.
You're a liar,
here.
BBF.
Do not talk
just
over your
just,
employer
just,
here.
Just shut your lying ass.
Do
just shut
over your employer. Do not talk over your employer here, Mary Lou, or
you
will. You
ain't my employer, BBF. Okay, I don't have an employer.
He just sent me a private message here on Discord. He says, you are my employer.
Oh, here we go again with another lie.
Lord have mercy. So, Mr. Grover Washington here, you are now an ambassador for God's Rainbow Ministries. I'm going to resolve you of all your sins here, and you will never have to take any sexual abuse from Mary Lou again here.
Yeah,
thanks a lot. I don't know what that meant, really, but thanks a lot.
Didn't mean a damn thing, Grover.
Miss Mary Lou, why do you go by the name of Kenneth Fishman when your name is Mary Lou?
My name is not Mary Lou, and it's never been Mary Lou. It's something you made up.
No, sir, I do not make up things here.
Yes, you did. Stop it. Just stop it. Okay? You're a lying son of a bitch. And let's not do Tony's final show this way. Okay? He's trying to have a show. Okay?
Yes.
Okay? And hopefully it's not going to be his last. Okay? Because I don't want it to be his last. I want it to stay on. Okay? I like listening to Tony Gaga. I've listened to Tony Gaga since the beginning.
Then why is it here that you are suing Mr. Tony Gaga?
I'm not.
Yes, you are, sir.
No, I'm not, sir.
I got a summons. I'm looking at it right now. It says Tony Fatata and Kenneth Mary Lou Fishman on the summons.
Well, see, that's a fake summons because it would not say Kenneth Mary Lou Fishman. Okay? You got a fake summons. Okay? Why don't you ask BBF who sent it to you?
So who sent it to me, Ben? Who sent it?
I don't know. Yeah, I didn't know.
Yeah, you do, because you used the name Mary Lou in it. Okay? It was you that sent the fake-ass thing. Okay? There would never be, okay, Kenneth Mary Lou, okay, on a summons. Never. Okay? Because my name is not Mary Lou. My name is Kenneth David Fishman, and it's always been that. Okay? It's never been lying bastard. Okay? So you're the one that sent fake-ass summons. That's why when you called San Antonio, they had no record of it.
Lord have mercy. Your legal name is Kenneth Mary Lou Fishman.
No, my legal name is not Mary Lou.
You
no,
are
it's
lying
not.
On the radio again here, sir.
You are lying.
Mary Lou. You are Mary
Stop
Lou.
Stop the lying. Stop
you
the
lying.
Sir,
you are
you
lying.
You are a lying bitch.
Mary Lord have mercy.
Okay.
Why don't you shut up and get off the phone?
Why don't you shut up and stop talking to me like that? You're supposed to be a man of God. You ain't nothing but a Mary Lou, lying Mary Lou.
Whatever. Okay?
Whatever.
There's no Mary Lou here.
You need to apologize to Tony Gaga for taking up all the time on the air here to go about
you
that
need
Mary
to
Lou
apologize
lying
to Tony
way.
Gaga for taking all the time on the air. Okay?
Why?
No one asked you to chime in.
Sir. You are lying. You are being a Mary Lou liar. And we had a conversation about it. Are you wearing your helmet and did you take your medicine there?
Oh, shut up. Just shut up.
Was that a fart? Okay, time out. All the shit's off the fucking table. Was that a fart? I want to know who farted. I want to know right the fuck now. Who just farted?
Benjamin Beaver Fontaine?
No, sir. I do not fart.
Yeah, you did.
Well, sir, that was my hot air balloon there.
Yeah.
I was talking, and there was a fart noise, and it came from somebody's mouth, and it's Mary Lou making fart noises here.
No, it wasn't me.
Are you making fart noises? Who's making fart noises? Okay.
Probably Grover or Benjamin Buber Fontaine. It's not me.
No, sir. No, sir. Look at it. I'm going to sing. La, 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 la. And there's going to be a fart noise coming, and it ain't going to be for me here.
Okay. All right. This is why my show's going off the air. This is why.
I don't blame you here. I don't blame you here because Mary Lou's making fart noises and being disrespectful like a little baby boy.
No, I'm not. I am not making any fart noises. Okay, you're unbelievable. You're unbelievable.
You are unbelievable. You're unbelievable. I want you to apologize to myself and Mr. Tony Gaga. I want you to say,
I want you to apologize. Okay? You're the one who needs to apologize. I haven't done nothing. Okay? I'm sitting here listening to this bull crap. Okay. Okay, and it's exactly what it is. It's bullcrap, and you know it. Okay, so.
Okay, yeah, I think you guys are shit pigs. Okay.
What?
Okay, keep playing recordings.
What are you talking about, shit pigs? Well, you're sending people. Who's sending shit pigs now?
Mary Lou's sending people shit pictures here.
ain't sending nobody nothing. Tony Gaga, you're in the fuck you Ken boycott chat room, okay? And I ain't sending nobody nothing, okay?
I wonder who named that chat room. The F U Ken room, yeah.
Yeah, that's the one you made.
No, sir. My room is called God's Rainbow. Lord, Mary Lou, do not interrupt me, Mary Lou. And if you want to say anything, it better be, I'm sorry, sir. That's what you need to say to me here.
I'm not saying I'm sorry to you. You got me mistaken.
Mary Lou.
You got me mistaken, sir.
Mary Lou, say you're sorry.
Nope.
Mary Lou, say you're sorry here, or you are going to be fired from God's Rainbow Ministries.
What? Sorry. Not gonna say it.
You just said it.
No, I didn't.
I did hear you say you're sorry.
I said sorry, not gonna say it.
This is good. It's a good start. Very good. Ken apologized. Now, Ben, you say you're sorry. And then you guys can be friends.
Well, here, since you apologize first, Mary Lou, I believe I will apologize. Lord, what is that smell?
What smell? You're on the red. There's no smell coming from my cell, Ben. Apologize to Ken.
I'm sorry you are lying, bitch, Mary Lou.
Okay. All right, that doesn't count as an apology. Ken?
Yep.
Ben and Ken. Ben, I need you to apologize. A real apology. And stop farting in the background, son of a bitches.
Yep, stop doing that, Benjamin.
No, that mess. I did not do that here. Now, listen here. Oh, you know what, Tony? I cannot tolerate the disrespect. I'm going to hang up here because this little Mary Lou is being nothing more than a Lord, forgive me for my language here, a little bitch here. And he's making fart noise. You are being disrespectful.
Bye, Ben.
Mr. Gaga.
Bye.
You are being disrespectful.
Well, I'm going to say, you know what? Goodbye to you all, fucking.
Okay, I'm trying to help you on the air. I'm trying to help you. And this is, okay, fine. You know, now you're saying goodbye and fuck it to me? That's not right.
I didn't say that at all.
You just said it. I heard it, Ken.
Nope, that was a recording. That was a recording. I never said nothing.
Why don't you take 8-5?
I have a record launching to the diabetes.
Okay, keep playing recordings. Okay.
Ben,
Benjamin,
goodbye. Ben, you have one more chance to say bye and apologize to Ken.
Mary Lou.
Helmet.
Mary Lou. I apologize that you are a little girl and your skirt is very small.
He's not going to apologize because he's an asshole.
Lord have mercy. Some pastor you are calling me an asshole.
Well, you are. I'm calling a spade a spade.
Just like you called DC2 a nigger.
I never called DC2 that N-word.
You called me
never
a spade?
Did.
You called me a spade?
I didn't call you a spade either.
Mr. Tony, I will be hanging up here. I will no longer speak to this racist. And ladies and gentlemen, I'm your new owner for God's Rainbow Ministries, and please give a listen to my new song called Lord Have Mercy. I'm a lyrical genius. Good night, Mr. Tony. Thank you very much for your participation here. And Mary Lou, stop trying to sue Mr. Gaga. Mary.
I And sue Mr. Gaga.
It's the summons has your name on it. It says Kenneth Mario Fishman.
It's fake, Tony. It's fake.
Anyway, good night, BBF. And thank you for not apologizing to Ken like you said you would.
Lord have mercy. I apologize. I said I'm sorry, Mary Lou, that you were such a little girl.
Okay. Goodbye, Ben.
Yep. Well, sorry about that, Tony. All the line that goes on by BBF. I'm sorry about it.
Well, there's someone else that wants to get on the air and talk to you. Hang on a second, Ken. I guess you're a hot topic tonight. Mm-hmm. Go ahead, caller.
Hello.
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 Hello, Rico.
How are you doing, Ken? How are you tonight?
I'm fine, Rico. How are you?
Very good. I just want to say, Tony Gaga, I sorry you have to stop your show because Mary Lou tried to sue you and take you to the court.
I didn't.
He said it's not him. He said it. The summons is fake.
It is. That's why when you called the San Antonio courthouse, they had no record of it, Tony.
Did I tell everybody who called the show? I gotta tell you who I is. You guys know who I is, right?
Yes.
Yeah, you're Rico.
Rico. Ramosito. Martini.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, that's right.
Do you like the music playing in the background? It's very romantic. It's actually me playing piano with my dick.
Okay.
And the name of the song is called The Ballad of Mary Lou. But like I want to say, thank you for the memories. And,
Ken.
Why you sue Tony to make him get rid of his show? Why you do this to him?
I'm not.
I mean, I have the summons, but I don't know if it's real or not.
It's not real, Tony. It's not real. It wouldn't have Kenneth Mary Lou Fishman on it. Okay, there would be no summons coming from a courthouse like that.
But this, your legal name is Mary Lou, and now you are being...
No, it's not Mary Lou.
You're ruining
everybody's
good fucking time. Everybody's good time on the Tony Gaga show. You're ruining everybody's good time.
Whatever. Bye, Rico.
No bye to Rico. You are being dick suck and ruining the show for everybody.
No, I'm not. No, I'm not. I'm sorry. Okay, I told Tony he can hang up if he wants to, okay, and go on with the show, okay?
This is why I'm ending the show, because of the summons. I got the summons in the mail.
Yeah, but it's not true, Tony. Okay, we didn't. It wouldn't have Kenneth Mary Lou Fishman on a summons. It wouldn't. That's crazy.
But you know, I've heard stories that I guess one of your family members' name was Mary Lou or something, and that's why you were named that. That's why it was your middle name.
My middle name is David. My middle name is David.
So this is fake.
Yeah, it's fake.
No, it's not fake. His real name is Mary Lou. He's a dick sock. And he is a dick sock for getting rid of your show. He want to take rid of your show because he want to be
the king
of... I don't
want to get rid of nothing. I like Tony Gaga. Okay, he's been a friend of mine, okay, as far as I'm concerned. Okay, not like you, you troll-ass Rico.
You say this to me?
Yeah, I say that to you.
I'm leaving.
Bye.
Dick sock motherfucker. You trying to get rid of Tony Gaga because you want to be the king of blog talk when you are nothing but
no,
the
I don't
want
to be king of nothing. I don't want to be king of nothing.
You're a king of dick sock.
Yeah, whatever. Goodbye.
Okay, Rico. Apologize to Ken. Apologize to Ken right now.
I'm not going to apologize to him because he a dick sock and he ruined your show. And then he tell everybody that you like to do sex to kids. And he send a picture all over the place on the internet with you trying to do a butt fuck to a child.
No. No. Never did that. You're lying.
No, I sent it to you on Discord. It's a picture of you.
Yeah, you're lying, Rico.
You're lying, dick sock motherfuck.
Okay.
Yeah, whatever.
This is getting ridiculous.
Yeah, I know it is, Tony. It's getting ridiculous. Why don't we just say goodbye? You know, I love you as a brother. And, okay, you can get on with your show, okay, because this is crazy.
You're on the show. You're ruining the show, Mary Lou.
You're ruining the show. Why don't you just stop it and apologize for being such an insolent individual?
Why you call me innocent individual? Thank God, I am very innocent. I never do.
I didn't say innocent. I said insolent.
Insolent, like a diabetic?
No. You don't even know the English language. Goodbye.
You don't know the English language. You say that I insulin, and then you say I innocent. Why you say this? I know innocent diabetic medicine. I don't understand why you say this to me.
I didn't say insulin. I said insolent.
You say insulin, and you speak like you have a dick in your mouth. Are you doing a dick talk to somebody right now?
Okay.
No, not like you.
Rico, thanks for the call. Can you say something positive before I hang up?
Yes, I say something positive. I'm going to say something positive. Tony Farrar, Tony Fiarova, is HIV positive.
Too far, Rico. Get off the air. And don't ever, they don't have to deal with you anymore, you son of a bitch. Get out of here. Ken, I'm sorry. That was too far.
Yeah, I know. It's all right, Tony. Okay? You know, it's been going on on your show for months now, okay? Which I haven't even... I called in one time and you never picked up my call. I was trying to... Okay, clear my name, and, but that's okay, okay, at least you did now, okay, and, I want you to know that I really don't want you to sit there and end your program. I really don't, okay, we're not suing you, okay, no one here, okay, planned on suing you, okay, so, okay, there's nothing happening on our end. Okay, so I just want you to know that.
I don't know what to believe because it's Joe's.
You can believe this. When you called the courthouse and they had no record of it, that's telling you that's a fake summons.
Hold on a second. This is actually... this is your lawyer that's calling in on a 111. Hang on a second.
Hello, I'm a lawyer.
Go ahead, 111. What do you hear? What do you say? What do you have to say about... Are you Ken's lawyer?
No, I'm not. I'm actually Roger Reeves. I don't know anything about the lawyer stuff.
Get out of here!
I don't have a lawyer, Tony. I don't need a lawyer.
The lawyer's supposed to be calling in from a 111 area code. And
I don't have a lawyer. So it's bull crap. Tony, don't even bother with it. It's not real.
Is this Ken's lawyer? This is Ken's lawyer. Hello. No. Okay, is this Ken's lawyer from 111? Did you say you don't have a lawyer?
I don't have a lawyer. Oh, I do not God. Have
one. Hello. Hello, everyone. How are you? Hello, Kenny. Hello, Tony.
Hello, Alfonso.
Do you guys get along, or are you guys going to fight, too?
No, we get along. I ain't got nothing bad to say against Alfonso.
We get along lovely, dear. He's a very nice person, Mac. Mary Lou's very nice, and he's very nice to my boyfriend now, Joe Gibson. And he was very nice when he let Rico come out of the closet. Darling, what's going on? Why are you stopping your show? What's happening? I'm going to miss your sexy voice every week. What's going on?
Alfonso, I have been threatened to be sued and everything, and now I guess it's not real. I don't understand. I don't know.
Well, so don't end your show, Tony. Don't end it. Okay, keep it going. Okay, we want you to keep it going.
I don't know. I...
Darling, let me tell
yeah,
you.
Yeah, I'm telling you the truth from the bottom of my heart. Okay, from the bottom of my heart, I love you, Uncle T. Okay, I never would do anything to hurt you. Period.
I believe him, Tony. Nobody wants Tony Talk to end, darling, because here's the thing. Normally, I meet up with a bunch of gay men in, like, Chili's bathrooms and stuff like that. But some of them are like, oh, my God, I heard your voice, and I know you as DJ Horsecock at the Alley Bar with Tom, T-H-O-M, hashtag Tom's Balls. Darling, you are the best on Blog Talk, and everybody talks about it. I mean, after I'm done having hot gay sex, whether I'm in a car, on a train, on a plane, on a bicycle, on a tricycle, on a unicycle, no matter where I am, one time I did it in a carnival cruise, except we did it on one of the lifeboats, darling, and it was amazing. It's all we talked about. Instead of pillow talk, it was Tony Talk. Hashtag Tony Talk after sex, darling. So, darling, we don't want you to end the show. And Mary Lou's a friend of yours. They would never take you to court. Aren't I right, Mary? I mean, do you like to be called Mary Lou? I don't understand. You sound like a
No, I don't like to be called Mary Lou because that's not my name, but that's okay. I understand you don't know, okay? But I would never take him to court. You're absolutely right.
But, darling, listen, there's so many people out there that love you, and they love your balls, just like they love Kenneth Mary. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to call you Mary Lou. But this is why there's so many things. You know what, darling? You're an international superstar. Did you know this?
I'm not international. No.
Oh, my God. Just the other day, I was in China, And I went over to China to hook up with Willy Wong because sometimes he needs a little horse cock in his life. And then he started turning straight, darling. He was going around. Speaking of Willy Wong, who has a big wong, it's very big for an Asian man. You're talking a whole 6-inch a pincher, darling. Hashtag 6-inch a pincher. And you should bring him on. He's going to be on a Chinese area code. It's probably +86, darling. You should probably answer because he loves you.
Oh, I see it right here. +80. Okay. Willie, hello?
The answer should be Willy Wong, get off of Long Island.
Hello, Willy. What do you hear? What do you say? Alfonso said that you were calling in?
Hello, darling Willy. My little egg roll. Nom, 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 nom.
Hi, Fonzie. Okay. I have really bad news from China. Uncle Jessica's there. I have jungle fever.
Jungle fever?
And God.
The Chinese doctors say I have a Wuhan flu because I eat the snake penis.
Do
I
eat a what?
3 hours. I ate the snake penis.
Hashtag
and
snake.
And now I have 3 hours to live.
Willie, no. Why don't you go to a doctor? You can't just diagnose yourself.
Don't have a doctor for snake penis flu and the jungle fever. Zanzi, it's mean. Bye forever.
Willie?
Yeah, Chuchu. Yes, Chuchu. Willie,
you gotta go to a doctor.
Oh my God, my darling Willie's dying. I'm never gonna see his Willie again.
Tony, I'm gonna go. I'm gonna be happy forever.
No, Willie!
I saw Alfonso have a big penis. And I'm gonna be happy in death.
Willie.
And I want to tell your fan, please don't eat snake penis.
Hashtag don't eat snake penis.
Bye for now. Bye forever.
No, Willie! You can't say bye for... Willie?
Oh my God, darling. Where's Pastor Ken? Kenny!
I'm right here.
You gotta say a prayer for Willie, oh my God.
Yeah, I'll say a prayer for Willie. Dear Lord, we come for our brother Willie, okay? It's not, nothing's forever, okay? Okay, you need to sit there and think about this.
Hello?
Hello?
Oh my God. Who's making weird noises? Yes. Is that you, Kenny?
Can I sing a song for you?
What? That was my fault. I hit one of the numbers by accident.
Oh, okay.
Oh, my God. That was terrible. I thought it was Mary. I'm sorry. I don't mean to call you Mary Lou, darling, but I thought it was one of you guys. I don't know what happened.
No.
Oh, my. Now, Kenny, I just want to say thank you. I've been a very big fan of God's Rainbow Ministries. I'm very upset that you had Benjamin Buford Fontaine, who wasn't very good to Rico, purchase.
I didn't have Benjamin Buford Fontaine. Okay, I never would have Benjamin Buford Fontaine part of God's Rainbow Ministries. He lied.
So that's not true, darling?
It's not true.
I don't know what to believe anymore.
I know that, Tony. Because people have been lying to you, okay, for so long, okay, and Benjamin Buford Fontaine is a troll, okay? He's always been a troll. He will continue to be a troll, okay?
Darling, I think you need to pick up 317 because they want to, I'm sorry, 713. I'm a little dyslexic here. If you want to give them a call. Darling, I think this is someone that's here to clear Ken's name before your show ends.
Oh, okay, hold on. 713. That is not somebody that wants to quit. Okay.
I'm sorry, darling. I'm so sorry. I'm sorry. Well, Mary Lou,
it's okay.
I'm so glad I finally got to talk to you, darling.
Glad to talk to you too, Alfonso.
I keep getting private messages about people trying to clear Ken's name here. And Ken, I'm trying. Hello? Go ahead. Hello?
It's all right, Tony. Don't worry about it. I don't need anybody to try to clear my name. I already know that my name is clear. Okay,
hello?
So it's all.
Hello? None of them want to clear your name.
That's okay. No. That's right. No big deal. Listen, I love you, Tony. Go on with your show. Okay?
Wait a second, Ken. Hello?
Yes. Hi. Hi, this is Andy. I wanted to talk about you being
this is the guy.
I'm
Hold
so
on.
Sorry.
This is the guy that wants to clear your name, Ken.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, I just wanted to say that that Ken did in fact send you to court. I actually
no,
yeah,
I didn't.
I was down at Haven for Hope. Oh,
quit,
well, no,
quit
I'm
lying!
Sure
I don't even know you. I don't hang out at
me,
Haven for Hope. Stop
it's
lying.
Andy. Well, I don't want to start any problems, Tony. But I would say this: he's sour because he started a soup kitchen at his house.
I didn't
and
start a soup kitchen at my house.
Can I speak? I'm just trying to speak.
No,
please,
you can't.
Speak,
you're
Ken.
A liar. Okay?
Tony,
you're a liar.
What
you started a bunch of BS, okay? By putting my information over the air, okay, on the last show, okay? So
Doug
just stop.
That.
Just stop.
Doug did that. I didn't do it. I'm trying to tell
you did.
That what happened.
What is happening?
Tony, what happened was this. I just want to tell you this very calmly. He started a soup kitchen, and it turned out to be a
That's
scam.
Right.
He was trying to get was trying to bring all these homeless people over, and he would take his pick, and which one were good looking. And, yeah, he was taking his pick, and he was offering them food, but in fact, He was just trying to serve him cock. It was horrible. And so he got caught up in kind of a legal issue, and he got upset because his buddy Doug, his partner, ended up putting out his address, and I guess he wanted to take all the eyes off of him, so he tried to sue you because I guess his address went up on your show at one point in time. But
yeah, because you did it.
No, it wasn't me. It was Doug.
No, it was you, Andy.
No, this is Andy. Andy.
I said Andy.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Hashtag.
That was messed up.
Hashtag, he said Andy.
Oh, good. Yeah, well, I mean, I feel it's pretty sad that you would do that, Ken. You'd start up a soup kitchen, get Grover over there.
I didn't start up a soup kitchen. It's a lie. Okay?
Well,
it's Grover a lie.
Showed up at your
that
place.
You started. It's a lie that you started.
Grover
okay.
was the one
just
who
stop it. You're not here to clear my name, so get off the freaking phone. Okay?
I just want to say one more thing. Go ahead, Tony. I'm sorry.
How are you clearing his name if you're telling me that he's running a soup kitchen but he's having sex with people?
Sorry. All I can say is this. If you look on the document itself, the paperwork that he sent off, because he's trying to sue you right now, at the moment, he just doesn't want to tell you right off the bat.
But no, I'm not trying to sue Tony Gaga, okay? My name is not Mary Lou. Never has been. Never will be. Okay, it's fake documents. Okay, so just stop it. Okay, get off the phone. Get off the phone.
Who is going to send me fake documents? Why would they be sending me these fake things?
Exactly.
Because they think you're gullible, right. You would believe it.
Never.
Yeah.
No. That's not true. That's not true. I want you to calm down.
It is true.
Mary Lou. Mary Lou, I need you to calm down. We're going to be very calm about this. I don't want any problems. I know that you, not only did you have, you had issues with starting the soup kitchen, and then you tried to start one down there in Corpus Christi with Tony Ferrar's mother.
Hey, you better stop. You better stop now. You're lying. I didn't try to start nothing in Corpus Christi, and you better leave Tony's family out of this. Do not bring up any addresses or any phone numbers or nothing. Because if you do, okay, you're an idiot. Okay?
Well,
you better stop.
That's really hurtful. That's really hurtful. I didn't say anything about
that. Hang up on this guy, Tony. He's a
fool.
Okay. All right. I don't know what's going on, but you shouldn't upset Ken. Okay. I gotta let you go. Okay. No, we gotta let you go because now Ken's upset. Okay. Ken, I'm sorry.
It's all right. It's all right.
I'm sorry. I was misled. I'm not. Oh my God. Kenneth. Can I call you Kenneth?
Yeah, you can call me Kenneth.
Darling, darling, hearing all of that, I'm sorry, but I can't be associated on the air anymore. I have to go, darlings. I love you both. Well, I love...
Okay, love you too, Abazo.
Okay, Tony, I'm going to send you a private message later, Tony. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Hashtag. Oh, my God. And thank you for if this is the last show, I want to thank you for all the memories, darling. All of them.
You're welcome, Alfonso.
Like, I remember the memory of me walking in the rain with my big cork wearing white pants and no underwear. And it was like a wet t-shirt contest, but it was a wet pant contest. And it was hashtag rock out with your cork out. And that's the best way of listening to Tony talk, is with a nice, stiff, hard, wet cork.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Alfonso.
Oh, one more thing. very important.
What's that? Goodbye, Alfonso. Thanks for the call. Anyway, Ken, thank you for sharing the last episode with me.
You're so welcome, Tony. You know I love you. Don't end your program. Really don't. Don't do it. Okay? You know? I mean, it was bad enough it was only once a week, okay? But hey, it was something to look forward to. Don't end your program. Really don't.
It's something to think about. It's something to think about.
Yeah, I mean, think about it hard, okay? I mean, because you got a lot of people who love you, Tony, and I'm included in that, okay? Okay, even though I mean, people have been impersonating me, okay, on your program, okay? I find it funny, okay? Okay, I mean, I know you didn't find it funny, but it was funny. Okay, that they could sit there and impersonate me and things like that going on. Okay, and also the fake Tony Furtado pretending to be whipping me or beating me. That was funny. Okay, it never happened though, but it was funny.
You didn't get beat up on the air.
No, I never got beat up on the air.
Ken, I'll be in touch. Thank you for the phone call, and I hope this. I'm sorry, everything happened, and I'll get rid of these summons papers if they're not real. And I didn't know you.
Yeah.
Thank you, Ken. And I'll talk to you later, my friend. Take care.
Okay. Love you, Tony.
Love you too, my friend. Take care.
Take care.
Well. So this is the last 2 minutes of the show. And I just want to say thank you to my fans, or my friends. And I'm going to miss you guys. But for now, I gotta ride off into the sunset and figure things out. I will be in Discord, and I will happily keep in touch with everybody. What is this last call? What do you hear? What do you say? Boston? Hello?
Yes, Tony, this is Father Chianti. I would like to wonder if I can say a couple of things to you.
You have 90 seconds. Go ahead.
I want to say goodbye.
Goodbye. Goodbye.
And goodbye.
What the fuck? You son of a bitch! What? Hello? Well, now I gotta find this the fuck out, you son of a bitch! God damn it! Bonacera, I'm very confused. Jesus. for Shiloh on our first day of school. You walked by me in the hallway as I stumbled like a fool over you. Did you see just what you were doing to me just before our first class? I just prayed that this would last just this moment, but this moment, but this moment went too fast. Just this moment, but this moment, but this moment went too fast. This is not a little crime. No, it's not a little crime. This is not a little crime. The beginning of June. In the end, was our last day of school. You walked by me in the hallway as I stumbled like a fool over you. Did you see just what you were still doing to me just before I was crushed? I just prayed that this would last just this moment, but this moment, but this moment went too fast. Just this moment, this moment wasn't meant to last. It's more than a little crush. This is more than just a crush. This is more than just a crush. Uh-huh.